bathroom for all hours, but you need it to arrive like now. If
what's your thing to do this?
Excuse me, a taxi driver. And he got fish for me. Today, what's your room? What? Most expensive prawns. You guys get any money? No, I'm not joking. 17 quid.
That was a costly mistake. With her seafood in hand, Tracy's got to get a move on if she wants to win that £1,000 cash prize.
Useful fresh prawns.
She scores her squid with a sharp knife.
It makes it look pretty for starts, when you charge with it, you have kind of a chance to look square as well.
And your black person.
It helps to keep it flat as well, because it's going to kind of, as soon as it's on the charge wheel, it's going to wrinkle up.
She adds prawns and scallops, covers with olive oil and lemon, and puts the seafood into the fridge to marinate till this evening, when she will char grill it at the last minute and serve it hot. With 2 hours to go, how are the guests feeling about this week's competition?
It's not very often you have dinner with complete strangers you've never met before, but I'm a bit nervous and apprehensive, so I'm not sure what you're like, but I feel I'm pretty good at getting on with people, so I do my best to make the party a party, if you know what I mean.
I guess I'm quite a competitive animal, and I will do the best I can.
I didn't look for this as a competition. I'm concerned to be a good host.
I'm just going to go in there and I'm going to do my best and just be the person that I know that God created me to be.
It's now 5 o'clock and time to make her rabbit casserole. First, our host makes her own bouquet garni for her sauce. Into leeks, she layers 3 bay leaves, herbs, the liver from the rabbit, and ties the whole thing up with butcher's string. She pours olive oil into a hot roasting tin and rubs with garlic.
Ouch.
Tracy coats the rabbit in flour and browns it in the oil. She then adds an entire bottle of red wine. Tracy sieves her homemade chicken stock and adds it to the casserole. She then adds her bouquet garni. And she's got a tip on how to cover the dish before it goes into the oven.
I'm going to cover this first of all with salt and pepper. So I've put metal foil directly on that, so wine can react to it sometimes and get it quite up. You can actually melt the foil before you know it. You've got foil in your stew.
And you wouldn't want that. Tonight, she'll add her prunes soaked in whiskey. Finally, she mixes up her whiskey cocktail.
It's a Hebridean sunset, some of the West Coast spent all my holidays with children in the West Coast. And I just love the name of it and the idea, you know, the colour of a Hebridean sunset, it's the orange and red all together. I just love that.
To whiskey, she adds Cointreau, Grand Marnier, grenadine, lots of orange juice, and lemon juice.
Excuse me, why is it?
Time for Tracy to light her fire.
A coal fire. I'm a little bit old-fashioned and a bit dirty, but I love my coal fire. Just like it. Light it on a cold evening, curl up on the couch because such fools now.
Oh, what a lovely scene. And the children even have a special nickname for their mum.
Their nickname for me is Scum.
Scum. In her bedroom, Tracy recalls the best meal she ever had.
It was a leg of lamb, cooked in red wine, and it was a bottle of whiskey, you know, it was salt, nothing else. And we woke up in the morning with the bone flying on the floor.
I did that with a kebab once. Time for a change of top, and our hostess is all ready to face her guests. First to arrive is
Paul. Hi!
Who just barged in?
Paul, hi, nice to meet you.